Good morning. Today I wanted to talk about different materials you can use to propagate your colocasias. Now the colocasias, they are two types when they reproduce. Like the yellow splash here, they have long runners shooting out from the mother plant. And the diamond head, the mojito, and aloha, for instance, and coral, they are clumpy. They has the babies come out near the mother plant, like in a clump. With the one that are clumpy, if you want to separate the baby, in my opinion, you should do it when you have like a lot of babies, and then separate it once, so the mother plant wouldn't take a lot of damage. But for the one that pushes out runners, like the yellow splash here, you can just simply cut out the runners. And you can cut the end. It was like this before. I chopped this one off to plant, and then you can cut each section. As you can see here, there's another one shooting out from this node. I'm not sure if it's called node. Sorry for my vocab. You can chop each one, like here is the new shoot that's coming out. Now, of course, these nodes will grow a lot slower than I would say the tip, the end part. Now you can see here, there's another one pushing out. So this is gonna be two plant. Okay, we're gonna continue with the planting material. Propagation material. I forgot. Not only there are colocasia that has runner and clumpy, some like the hybrid over here, she's called Queen of Phoenix. She also pushes out runners, long runners, and had the baby plant shooting out from just as like clumpy as the coral and aloha, just like that. So she's a hybrid, so she have both characters. Okay, now we're gonna start with the first material I used. Now this, if I pronounce correctly, it's cocoa coir. Again, I'm not sure about the pronunciation. Or some people might call it cocoa peat. It's basically just similar to peat moss, but it's made from coconut husk. It retains a lot of water, a lot of moisture. Now this is like a week of propagation, and you can see the roots are shooting long. Now the trick of using this material with colocasia is you fill the pot like one third of the pot, then you pluck your plant in, and then you water them. And then what I would do is I have like a tray, I fill the water up to about half, about the same level, a little less than your planting materials. You see, it was about here. Now, after you do that, you just leave it in the shade, or if you're propagating the runner like this, the internodes, the nodes. Now this kind, when you put it in the material, your planting medium, you can place it under direct sunlight. Now you still have to have a tray of water, but you can put it under direct sunlight because they has no leaf yet. But this one has leaf already, so it will not be able to tolerate direct sunlight straight away after your cut. But this will. This is from my experience, and I'm quite certain that it will survive. Like, I would say it has a 98% success rate on any planting medium I use. Now Thailand has like really hot, scorching summer and raining season. But this right now is kind of a windy winter season. Now this is the first winter for most of my colocasias. Now, extra tips on these internodes propagation. If you use coco peat or coco coir, like over here, you place it, basically you just place it on top of your planting medium like that. Just sink it in just a tiny bit so it stayed like that. Yeah, that's a just demonstration. And then you would have a tray of water, but less than these grown plants already. So basically you just let the water touch the bottom of your pot just a little bit so it can suck up the water, because the coco peat, coco coir, they have a great ability to absorb moisture and water. So they will suck up the water, and that would be enough for the little guy over here.
Okay.
And it doesn't matter if it's the tip, like this one, the tip part, or the nodes, the internode, like this. Never use fertilizers when you propagate colocasia. Never. They, even if they have some kind of roots like this, they're not ready yet to absorb any fertilizers. So just plant them like this. No fertilizers, they just need water. And again, no direct sunlight for the one that already have leaves. But the nodes, the internode, you can put them under direct sunlight. They will survive. In my experience, 95-98% survive both type. Now, I didn't say like no sunlight, like not direct sunlight for the one that already have leaves. Not direct sunlight. You can place under like in front of your garage, at the a shade of your house, or under a bigger tree that had lots of light, but not getting hit by direct sunlight. Now, where I'm living, it's a hot and humid place. I cannot, my experience and my tips might not apply to you guys that live in colder climates. I don't have any experience with that, so you gotta, if you somehow seeing this video, you need to take that to consider. Okay. Now that would be it for the coco coir or coco peat. Thank you for watching. Bye.